Hi. It's the second day after Christmas, 2017, and this is not my fireplace, but this is where I live, and it's a beautiful place. And there's one thing I've been pondering about lately, and that's witchcraft. Witchcraft, discernment, and familiar spirits, false prophecies, and these type of things. And I don't think people realize how close they are to actually doing witchcraft. Because they want certain things badly, or they have been in a church or congregation or with friends that are either encouraging them or they are watching other people, on the internet performing witchcraft. And it's what you're doing is playing with spiritual forces that are real. I mean, they're not imaginary. And I have myself been thinking, and I've been seeing healing because I have seen extraordinary healing. I know that in Matthew 7:21, Jesus says, this people standing in front of him, and they are referring to casting out demons, prophecies, and doing it in the name of Jesus. And there's something, there's really something. It's that specific verse, Matthew 7:20, 7 verse 21 and forward, has been on my heart for a long time. And it's something, it's really made me uncomfortable because of the healings I've seen myself. And and I do know that you can't claim to be a believer even though you cast out demons and you see the healings and such. Those, I believe, I've come to believe that a man can receive an authority from God when he's born again, but he misuses it. And you can even throw out demons from people that are not ready. And I've done so a couple of times. And what happened is they were worse afterwards than they were before I threw it out. I remember one woman, this is a few years back. And I prayed for her, and there was not. I mean, she didn't receive. That's. I'm not saying don't throw out demons to people when they don't, when they have the knowledge or the discernment. If they're believers, and they're truly, repenting and turning around. I'm not saying it's, dangerous to throw out demons with the persons, but if you don't listen to the Holy Spirit, it's a bad thing. So I remember this woman. She had a lot of pain and such, and I was quite certain that you had, she had demonic manifestations or powers within her body. So what I did is like I prayed over her. I didn't do that. I throw you out in the name of Jesus. I didn't do any such thing. But by the authority that was given to me, you don't have to, when you've been given the authority from Jesus, you have a power that's beyond, it's not beyond control, but you don't have to scream if if you're running an excavator and you're pulling levers and all these things to like this huge machine. You don't have to scream at it. And I think it's the same thing when you have been given an authority of God. You can't control it. You don't have to scream it in order to control it. Well, sometimes you can get frustrated and all these things. But still, so I prayed for this woman, and what happened a few nights after, it was, I think it was the night, maybe night after, I don't remember. And what happened is she was in a terrible state. She was sweating. It was a terrible night. And I think that the spirits, they fought to get back into her. But I didn't dare to tell them that, what you're doing is a spiritual fight. I should tell them. Now that I realize it. And also, another instance, a man came to me and I gave him my stereo because we're moving. And I began to speak with him and he said, he had spirit manifestations in his house and such. They were, pulling off the sheets and during the night. And so he knew. Without being even a being Christian, I mean, he knew there were spiritual manifestations in the house. It was all demon possessed, if you like. And so I came to visit them, the family, and it was like death all over. I mean, written. They had pillows with, skulls painted on them, and he had lots of weapons on the wall and everything. It was steeped in demonic, symbolism. And I don't know what he's been doing, but I think when you're attracted to death, or children watching the different movies and such, and they look like, dead, especially those, vampire movies and all these things. And you're attracted to it. There's a reason. It's like, whoa, this is exciting type of thing, but it's actually a doorway into the child itself. And it's the same thing with Harry Potter. Harry Potter is kind of like a cool thing, but it's a doorway of spiritual power that the children don't recognize. And what's happening is they become senseless to it. Their bodies become thwarted in a sense, and even speaking the word of Jesus, even speaking truth to them, and they'll turn around from it. And it's a terrible thing. I've seen it in my own family. In my own family. Getting rebuked by the parents because you speak the truth to them. And they're forgetting their own powerful testimonies from the past, even. It's a weird thing. But spiritual forces in the TV and everything, it's like, gets onto you. So I believe this man, when I came to him and I saw the house and everything, he had a family, children and such, I was like, I knew God had spoken to me, but in retrospect, that is, I didn't, when God said, before I went to this man, God spoke to me and said, you need a bow. You need to obey me. But I didn't. I wasn't. I was stubborn. I was like, no, that can't be God. Do, 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 do. But still, when I spoke to that man, I was like, no, it's just because you have symbolism of dead skulls and all these things. Well, I didn't. That's not exactly what I said. But I was like, no, rejecting. It's no. You don't have a. It's not a problem. We'll just pray for the house and it'll go away. Do, do, do. But the thing is, every man, woman, or place, if we've received spirits into that place, and they have a right to stay there. I mean, you can't just like I'm going to throw out the demon and not take care of the real problem, the root of the problem. You have to take care of the root. So I was stupid. I didn't tell him the truth. I should have told him the truth. I was immature at the time. That was a few years back. But it requires, speaking the truth requires stamina. It requires, you need to be, you can't be afraid of people when you're doing ministry of God. If you're supposed to be a minister of God and you're just like, ooh, I'm just saying the thing so I can get, the money and it all seems nice and everything. Well, even the money, so many bad manifestations that'll come from it. And so when it says like fear God and not man, it means you need to respect God and don't respect man. Well, love God, love man, but don't love them for what they do. Love them for what God wants you to do. Love them for God's value on them. But just like Paul, you know, spoke to this, you know, this, you've seen sorcerers, Simon the sorcerer in the Bible. And when, you remember this, at this one point in time, I don't remember the scripture, but Paul was speaking to a man and his, you know, eyesight just went away. It's, we're not supposed to be like, you know, cozy teddy bears around spiritual powers that are manifesting on people and so, but we need to use discernment. We need to know what we're doing, and we need to speak truth to people, even though it's kind of, we're afraid of losing our face, and we can't accept spiritual forces into our own lives. So that's basically what I want to speak about. So wishing you Merry Christmas and a blessed New Year. Jesus Christ, if you haven't received him, you need to open up, you need to receive him. You need to ask God into your life. Receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. He is the only one that can truly set you free. And so, don't go, if you believe you have demonic forces within your own body, it's not just about getting them out, but you need to be staying on the path, because if anyone casts them out and you're not free from the root problem, you're up for a huge problem when they're trying to get back into you. And also, when you're finding a church, be sure to ask God if this is a good church or not. Many churches don't move in the full authority that God has given to them. They are, you know, some are infiltrated. I don't think I've seen an infiltrated church. But I'm a simple man, but still I've seen wonderful healings and cast out spirits and demonic forces and such. But still, ask God, because he can speak directly to you and through the Bible and through, you know, if you have this good feeling of this, you know, of friends in the church and your brothers and sisters, and it's really work together. And God will help out. So I speak a blessing over you all, and I pray that you will listen to God and spend time with him. He's a wonderful father. I can only, you know, he's done wonderful things in my life. And so this is, even in scarcity, I mean, materialism, it's like, when I have little, which I at times really do, I'm still blessed by remembering all the good things God has given to me. And some of the experiences I've had is just like mind-blowing. And it's like he's a good, good father. Woo! God is good. So don't be afraid. There's always a solution. And be encouraged. Thank you. Hey, bye.